has to start with those people in the kitchen. It has to start with those people who are serving and preparing the dinner to be served on Sunday and Wednesday night. The people in the kitchen have to be on one accord. Don't make yourself bigger than the group. What I don't want to hear from you anymore, generally, is this just the way I am. The next time I hear it, I'm going to flip out. Can I just say that? You can't lead the way you are. So change it.
Amen. Amen.
Let us love one another. Let us respect one another. Let us endure one another in the bonds of peace. We need to do that for the people that's coming in these doors. Let me tell you something. Love is something you can feel in the environment.
Yes.
I am telling you in the name of Jesus. When somebody walk in an environment where there's love, they feel the peace of that love. Are we on the same page? I'm done. If you're a leader, say amen.
Amen.
If you aspire to be a leader, say amen.
Amen.
This is Leadership 101. You are a servant. You're to serve the people who follow you.
Amen.
Not to fight with the other leaders. Why would the enemy got to fight you if you're killing one another? Everybody just do your hand like this. Let us pray together. And glory to God. I never think that a church service is a waste of time. And if you made it here tonight, you fought your way to get here, it's because God has purpose in this for you. I want everybody with your hands like this tonight to see this, and I want you to make a commitment within yourself. I'm going to be the best me I can be.
Amen.
Hallelujah. I'm going to be the best leader I can be. I'm going to be the best follower of my apostles that I can be until my Lord comes. But I want you to make a commitment to yourself, man, that I am not going to be a part of strife. In my home, at my job, in the ministry, no matter where I go, I'm just not going to be a partaker in strife. I want you to make this commitment with yourself. I'm going to walk away from strife. I'm going to walk away from negativity. I'm going to walk away from saying condescending things. I'm going to walk away from being critical. I'm going to go out of my way to love the people next to me. I don't always have to like them, but I have a command to love them. I want you to make this commitment. Even when they do things I don't like and I don't understand, I am not going to be in strife. I'm going to be a partaker in the peace. I'm going to be a peacemaker. I want to be called a child of God. If I got to die to be at peace with you, I will do that. Don't expect me to stay dead. You make your adjustments too. Let us pray. Righteous Father, this is a glorious moment, Father. And we thank you for the presence of your Spirit. Father, I pray today once again in the intercession for your leaders here at Gen 11, for all of your children here at Gen 11, Father, that the peace of God, that their understanding, all of our understanding would be enlightened, Father, that we may know what is the joy and the power of being a servant of Jesus Christ. Father, I pray that you grant grace, that humility would come upon us. Humility would come upon our hearts, Father, that righteousness would reign in every area of our lives. I ask that you would grant grace to every leader, every aspiring leader, Father, every member of genuine love, that we would walk in love, walk in the fullness of God, in the love of God. I believe, Father, that we receive that tonight. I thank you for it. We receive your abundance, we receive your harvest, and I pray that every soul in this building would walk in harvest with the testimony of your greatness. In Jesus' name, if you receive it, say amen.
Amen.
If you receive it, say amen.
Amen.
Clap your hands and give God praise. Amen. God, don't sound like victorious people to me. I guess she's not here because she had a death in her family suddenly today. One of her cousins, I guess, had a heart problem or something, just suddenly passed. And she called me today and I am. So please pray for her. Sister Vivian is recovering from some procedures she had to go through. We hope to see her on Sunday if it be God's will. Pray for her. I believe we have a card or something for her, a gift. If you want to be a partaker, if you want to sign the card, By the time I found out from Pat, it was too late to get here. Give us something on Sunday, man, a card, a condolence card or something. But please be prayerful for those people who are going through things at this time. And I'm sure there are many that we don't know about, but those are the ones that I know. Amen?
Amen.
Amen. So we're getting ready to go home now. So let us bring our...